Over there, I did my bachelor's in electrical engineering and master's in polymer. So what happens is here, I have a more option of this delineated security in the sense I'll be able to brief my soldiers or brief my staff to be very alert at the targeted areas where the devastation could be exponentially high. So like I'll be delineating those particular areas with this particular knowledge. So that is one way it will help. And when coming to the understanding of the technology and helping my staff understand the technology and bridging the technological connect which is required in maintaining the security, I will be able to do so.
CISL is deployed in Delhi Airport and other airports also.
Yes.
Can you name the gadgets which are being used by CISL right now?
Gadget. One is those sensors which they use when you are checking. Those are metal detectors. And the baggage which they use, they are IR sensors, infrared sensors, where they do some sort of imaging, IR imaging.
Mm-hmm.
These two and as per my knowledge, I know these two.
Can you name like where CISL is deployed apart from this Delhi Metro and airports? What are the important installations,
sir,
which CISL is protecting?
Sir, the mines, oil refineries, nuclear reactors.
Can you name those mines like where CISL is deployed?
Sir, the bauxite mine which is there, I'm unable to recollect. I'm sorry about it, sir.
So, like you have even submitted a research paper on fiber and polymer.
Yes.
So can you explain what is fiber and what is polymer?
Yes, sir. That research paper was basically on air filtration mask that was designed from Celsin, which is a waste product of silk industry. And coming to the fundamental difference between fiber and polymer, polymer is a superset and fiber is a subset of polymer where the fiber definition is fundamentally based on the structure of it, where a parameter called aspect ratio comes in. Aspect ratio is nothing but the ratio of length to its diameter. When it is more than 1000, you classify that particular thing to be fiber. And if something, and fiber most of the times is made up of polymer. So that is superset and fiber is subset of polymer.
Hi, Kesai Gautam. You are from Andhra Pradesh, right?
Yes.
Have you heard about Kapoor community? It is very famous right now.
Yes.
What is it?
Kapoor community, it is one of the communities which were actually engaged in agriculture at some point of time. And as the things changed, what happened was they were considered to be very rich at the times when Jamindari was going on. As the time passed by, we have seen the abolition of Jamindari taking place, and at that time the concentration of this particular community on education was very bleak. So in the developmental phase, they were unable to cope up with the development stream that is taking place in the state or in the country. Because of this, they have been fighting for reservation, and recently the state government has passed a bill which is awaiting the necessary proceedings in central government.
So don't you think it goes beyond the range of 50%?
Yes, ma'am. They have given 6% or 5%. So when we total up the total reservations in Andhra Pradesh, it is summing up to 55% around. It goes above the Supreme Court judgment, that is Indra Sahni's case, if I am not wrong, of 1993, which justified this reservation policy of 50%. So it goes against it.
Okay. Sure. And tell me one thing, what is the NCRAC? You have heard about NCR? Delhi NCR.
Yes, ma'am.
So, can you explain what is that?
NCR is nothing but the the urban outgrowth of the Delhi city. It is that's what I think.
And you have read Polity and all the things. Can you tell the final interpreter of the Constitution? Final interpreter of Constitution. Who is the final interpreter of Constitution?
Final interpreter of the Constitution.
Final interpreter of the Constitution. It is the Supreme Court.
Okay. And the custodian?
Custodian is President.
Good. What is the ozone layer and where it forms? What is the ozone layer?
Ozone layer.
Yeah.
Ozone layer, it is a layer present in stratosphere which is screening the UV rays from reaching into the Earth's surface or the reaching into the tropospheric atmosphere. Karnool, presently I am staying at Karnool.
Okay, so name the river that passes through Karnool.
Sir, Karnool, Tungabhadra and Krishna, sir.
Krishna and Krishna?
Sir, Krishna passes through. Krishna, sorry, it passes through the border. Mm-hmm. And I am in the Mahbub Nagar area. The Karnool, Tungabhadra passes through.
Okay, name that. Actually, you have given many exams before this.
Yes.
So, name the three events in world history that changed the course of world history.
So, one was the block of Silk Road, the Ottoman Empire, the Ottoman Empire. I mean, the Silk Road blockade which that took place in 14th century.
Thank you.